Rob O'Donnell, Halish Negrania, Conde Limni.
So I'm living in Dingle at the moment and I'm working as a tour guide. It is good crack because I'm able to express myself.
There'll be a newfoundland, it'll be like Christopher Columbus, we'll discover something.
I describe Robert as a very outgoing person. He'll sit down even if it's just with a stranger and he'll listen to them no matter what they have to say.
You never know what Robert's going to do next. He's just that type of young fella, but always very open and very honest.
Rug Rob Grimer and Gumon Igishog, August on the Mind, Sonilyage.
Sure, he grew up beside the field. He was constantly in the field, and I was always in the field. So I suppose he got it from me because I'd always at home the whole time. But I don't know, he just tucked it like, I suppose, a duck to water. He never stops hauling. He's constantly hauling his end.
He did actually get called up for his county at one stage. But Robert went playing a rugby match the night before and broke his thumb.
Tatoire Rob. Marjouler no suile at Aige.
Through the years, from I lived in Hawaii, I lived in San Francisco, and I would have lived with hippies and I would have lived with farming communities. And so grounding and earthing your feet on the ground was a way of balancing my body. It was good for your health, so.
He comes down to my house in Waterford. I'm like, put on your shoes, please. We're going, like, to dinner with the family. My sister even brings shoes for him, like.
So one day I decided to wear no boots in a match, and my dad was actually over the team at the time.
I told him that he wouldn't get far if I was marking him because I'd be standing on top of his toes marking him.
Rinu mar scapa eacht Rob, nor a scorolche a hain a hain teag, agus e gimmerton chliche, cos nochta.
You won't see many young fellas who will score 111 barefoot, you know, and it's inspiring though, like, in fairness.
The matches and everything was a euphoria. It was wild and it was great, like, really good. It's just, I was most at peace when I was on my own. I had a void inside that wasn't filled, and I knew there was something majorly wrong. I'd used cocaine, and I used magic mushrooms once as well, which had a bad impact on me. It probably damaged my nervous system more. Alcohol is a drug for me. I use it as a drug to sedate myself. It's been an unhealthy relationship for many years.
Agus gachra de dolanonas, daily grab gomerica.
Within that time frame, I was showing signs of probably psychosis, maybe through some actions. I was showing signs of delusions.
I just knew he wasn't well. Like, I knew that he'd have to go someplace or get more professional help that I couldn't give him.
Tareisto fila overica, hecoil rabasjach in ained shikietrach.
Never hit me really until Robert did get sick. That there was anything wrong with him, and to see him in a psychiatric unit, it really hit home, didn't it?
The biggest and hardest thing I ever heard come out of his mouth was, I don't want to be alive. I just thought I was going to lose my best friend.
When I remember being in bed, and the suffering was so real that if there was a button beside me, I would have pressed it. It would have been the easiest thing to do. In the end, I was a nervous wreck, and I had to rebuild from scratch, like, you know.
He was going to find a cure for it no matter what.
I worked on my shame and I dissolved my shame. Now it's easier for me to talk about anything because I have no shame.
If it wasn't for his hurling, I don't think he would have come as far as he did today.
We're fighters, like, and I suppose he said, if I don't fight this, it's going to consume me and it's going to kill me. So I'm going to fight it. And he did fight it.
I was pushing away myself. And now I'm being myself more and my life is much easier.
I'm proud of him because he's always true to himself. And he doesn't care what people think. Because, you know, why should he?
Underdogs, it boards like Greenfields Digital Sports Technology, creators of the Smart Schlitter.